Hello everyone, Alex here from warrenoffkeys.com, and in this video I'm going to show you how you can use APIs to create a command that is going to generate pictures of a cat or a dog or some type of meme depending on the API that you use. So in this video I'm going to show you how to use a cat command, so whenever you type exclamation point cat it'll display an image of a random cat, but the same concept can be applied to any other API that is similar to this. So real quick, before we start, if you do need help with anything, feel free to leave a comment down below, or better yet, ask in the Warren Off Keys Discord server, and I'm sure someone will be able to help you there. So with that said, let's get started. Here I'm in this project that I've been working on throughout this series. A link to the GitHub repository with this project will be in the video description. I'm going to be using the Commando framework, and if you don't know how to use that, I do have a video on how to use that within the video description as well. So to start off, I'm going to go inside my commands directory, and inside of misc, I'm going to make a new file. This will be called cat.js. And then in here, I want to create a very basic command that will just reply with some type of text whenever I run the command, just to make sure everything is working. So the first thing I have to do is import the Commando framework. So I can say const commando with a capital C. This is going to equal require discord.js/commando. Now after that, we have to export a class. And this class will have to extend commando.command to inherit all of the functionality that commando gives us when creating a command. So I can say module.exports. This is going to be a class called cat command, and this is going to extend using the extends keyword commando.command. We can then open up curly braces, and now we are within our class. We then want to listen for a constructor function. This is going to be ran whenever a new object using this class is created. This is going to have one argument, which is a client. And within here, we have to call a constructor function for the command class that we are extending. Now within JavaScript and most languages, in order to do this, you have to call the super function. This is going to typically call the constructor of whatever class you are extending. And this takes two arguments. The first one is the client. The second one is an object that's going to contain some information. One piece of information is the name of the command. So this will just be cat. We're going to have a group, which will be misc because we are inside the misc folder. We can have a member name, which will also be cat, and we can have a description, which would say displays a random picture of a cat. Obviously, you can add in whatever you want there. Next, we want to add an asynchronous run function. So I can say run equals async, and this will be its own standalone function. This is going to give us a few different types of arguments. The first one will be the message. And then after that, I can just simply say message.reply. Works. So now I can save this and I can run my bot with node index.js. I could then go into Discord. Here we see that tutorial bot is online. I can do exclamation point cat and it's going to reply with works. So I know that this is working so far. I can go ahead and delete these messages. And now we are going to want to use an API. So I can go into Chrome, and after using a Google search, I found this API here. You can search for dog picture API or meme picture API or anything like that, and you should find what you're looking for. Now, the exact implementation for every API is going to be slightly different, but I'm going to try my best to explain the concepts here so you can take the concepts you're learning in this video and then apply those to whatever API you want. So typically, you're going to look for some type of documentation. We see up here on the navigation, we see docs. So I can click on that, and this is going to open this up in a new tab. This is usually going to have some type of information. Now, if you're completely new to APIs, the concept here is that they have some type of code that is hosted on their own servers, and a certain URL, for example, this right here, is going to allow us to access a certain part of that code that performs some type of task. So if I copy this and I open this in a new tab, we are then going to see this thing right here. Yours might look a little different. I do have an extension to make this more readable, but if I keep refreshing, we're going to get different information here. So I don't know if you can tell, but the width, let's say 768, so if I keep refreshing, this changes. Now, if I open up these images here, we see there's a GIF of a cat. If I refresh, we get another image, just another cat there, and I can keep on refreshing, and it's going to give us random pictures of cats. So this is an API endpoint, which is what this is called, and this is something we can load using something called a GET request. Now, every single time you load a URL into your browser, such as google.com or youtube.com or anything like that, that is technically a GET request. And there's a couple different types of requests, but I'm not going to go into too much detail with that. It's out of the scope of this video. But a GET request essentially asking for some type of information. Now, whatever is returned, such as Google's homepage, YouTube's homepage, or this API right here, whatever is returned is going to be the result that their server gave us, depending on the request we specified. So now we can simulate a GET request on this URL using a package called Axios. So I'm going to stop my bot and I'm going to run npm install Axios. And we can also do a Google search for this package. So I can do npm Axios. And we are going to see the top result right here. Clicking on this will give us some information. So we see that 11 million weekly downloads. This is a very popular package because it is one of the easiest ways to perform API requests within Node. So scrolling down, we see browser support. It doesn't really matter too much because we're using this in Node. Scrolling down further, we see how to install it, which is the command we just ran. We see other installation options which aren't relevant for us. And then we see code examples. So performing a GET request. So as you can tell, this is all capitals. If I scroll down further, you'll notice that other requests such as post are typically in all capitals. That way it stands out as not just some other word, a part of a sentence or anything like that. This is going to be a GET request as part of an API. So everything here is going to be the actual example. First, we import Axios and then we say axios.get. And here we have some type of endpoint, which is going to be the URL that we see right here. Then after that, we are using .then because this returns a promise. And this is going to give us some type of response. We can also use .catch, which is going to handle any errors. And then a final .then is optional, but this is always executed. We're typically only going to have one .then and .catch, but in some cases you might have multiple depending on the API you're accessing. So let's get started by using this. We can import Axios because we've already installed it. So going in here, I can say const Axios. This is going to equal require Axios. And then whenever we are actually working with this command, we then want to use the Axios system. So going back to the documentation, we see axios.get and then the endpoint. So I'm going to copy the endpoint and I'm going to say axios.get and we're going to paste in the endpoint right here. And then we're going to have a .then, which is going to have a callback function here, and then also .catch, which will also have a callback function. Now the .then is going to have a response. So I'm just going to say res, and then I can console log the response just like this to make sure that we understand what it's going to return. Now the catch is going to be used if there's ever an error. So I can say err, and then I can console.error saying what the error is. I can then save this and I can run my bot again with node index.js. And going back into Discord, I can then run exclamation point cat. So here we see our result. Let me go ahead and expand the console. And if I scroll up, we see this response right here. So there's typically going to be a lot of information that we don't need to know about. All of this nonsense here, we don't need to know about any of it. The useful stuff is typically going to be inside of a data property like this. And then here's an array. And this is an array that is very similar. If you look at it, we have an ID, a URL, width, and height. And if we look at the actual API call, we see the same type of information here. So I'm going to try and access the data property. And depending on the API you're using, the data property may not be there. Every single response that you get from different APIs and even different endpoints is going to be completely dependent on what those APIs and endpoints are. So if you're doing this with a different API, for example, for dogs or even a different cat API, the response will be different because it completely depends on how the API creator designed it. But typically you're going to get a JSON object back and then you can access the necessary information through that API. So here I'm going to try and console log data, the property right here, and we should get an array of objects. So going in, instead of just response right here, I can say response.data. I can then restart my bot. And then I can run exclamation point cat. And it's then going to return just this single object. So because this is an array, I'm assuming that this API allows me to pass in some type of information that would return multiple objects. I'm not going to get into the details of that, but we want to access the first element, which is index 0. And then we want to access the actual URL. So if I save this and I restart, we should now see only the URL being displayed in our console. Whoops, I just accidentally installed Axios again. Let me start the bot. And then going back, I can do exclamation point cat. We now see the actual URL right here. So now we want to actually display that in the channel. So I can take this and I can just simply say message.reply with the actual string. And then I can restart the bot and I can run exclamation point cat. And it is then going to give this picture right here. If I do it again, it'll give a different cat picture, just like this. And of course, if I keep doing this, you're going to see different pictures of cats that this API provides. So this is a very basic GET request within APIs, and a lot of different API calls will be much more complicated than this. And there's typically a lot to APIs, honestly. There's many different ways to access the information. Oftentimes you have to pass information through multiple different ways to the API to return something. If this is the first time that you're trying to use an API, then be sure to follow the exact API I'm using and this exact use case, because it can be much easier for you. But if you're trying to use a different API and you're having problems, try joining the Worn Off Keys Discord, and there might be some people who can help you there. Thanks for watching this Discord.js tutorial. If you want to learn more about Discord.js, consider clicking on the playlist you see on your screen now. If you need help, feel free to leave a comment or ask in the Worn Off Keys Discord, which can be found in the video description.